Hello everyone, welcome to AJJ Engineering. Today I would like to discuss with you the topic material science, under which I would like to discuss the types of engineering material, types of bonding, crystal structures, imperfection of solids, introduction to phase diagram and solid solution. Types of engineering materials. There are 5 types of engineering materials, mainly metals, semiconductors, ceramics, polymers and composites. Metals. A solid material which is typically hard, shiny, malleable, fusible and ductile with good electrical and thermal conductivity. Example, iron, gold, silver, aluminium and alloy such as steel. Semiconductors. A solid substance that has a conductivity between that of an insulator and that of most metals, either due to the addition of an impurity or because of temperature effects. Devices made of semiconductors, notably silicon, are essential components of the most electronic circuits. Ceramics. A ceramic is a solid material comprising an inorganic compound of metal or metalloid. Common examples are earthenware, brickline and brick. Polymers. Polymers are materials made of long repeating chains of molecules. The materials have unique properties depending on the type of molecules being bonded and how they are bonded. Example, plastics, that is nylon, teflon, polyester and rubber. Composite. A composite metal is a material made from two or more constituent materials with significantly different physical or chemical properties that, when combined, produce a material with characteristics different from the individual component. Example, reinforced concrete, plywood, fiberglass, etc. Types of bonding. Ionic bonding. This is the bond when one of the atoms is negative as an extra electron and another is positive as lost an electron. Then there is a strong direct Coulomb attraction. An example is sodium chloride. In this molecule, there are more electrons around chlorine forming Cl- and less around sodium forming Na+. Ionic bonds are strongest bonds. Covalent bonding. In covalent bonding, electrons are shared between the molecules to saturate the valency. The simplest example is the H2 molecule, where the electrons spend more time in between the nuclei than outside, thus producing bonding. Metallic bonding. In metallic bond encountered in pure metals and metallic alloys, the atoms contribute their outer shell electrons to a generally shared electron cloud for the whole block of metals. Atoms self-organize in crystals. Most of the time, the crystalline lattice is a periodic array of atoms. When the solid is not crystalline, it is called amorphous. Example of crystalline solids are metals, diamond and other precious stones, ice, graphite. Example of amorphous solids are glass, amorphous carbon, amorphous silicon and most plastics. Unit cells. The unit cell is the smallest structure that repeats itself by translation through the crystal. The most common type of unit cells are the faced centered cubic FCC, the body centered cubic BCC and the hexagonal closed packed HCP. Other types exist, particularly among minerals. Polymorphism and allotropy. Some materials may exist in more than one crystalline structure. This is called as polymorphism. If the material is an elemental solid, it is called allotropy. An example of allotropy is carbon, which can exist as diamond, graphite and amorphous carbon. Polycrystalline materials. A solid can be composed of many crystalline grains not aligned with each other. It is called polycrystalline. The grains can be more or less aligned with respect to each other. Where they meet is called a grain boundary. Imperfection in solids. Any irregularity in the pattern of crystal arrangement in a solid lattice is called imperfection in solids. The occurrence of defects take place when crystallization, the process of formation of crystals, occurs at a very fast or an intermediate rate. This is because particles don't get enough time to arrange themselves in a regular pattern. Materials are not stronger when they have defects. The study of defects is divided according to their dimensions. 0D, that is point defects, vacancies and interstitials impurities. 1D, linear defects, dislocations, that is edge, screw, mixed. 2D defects, that is grain boundaries, surfaces. 3D boundaries, 3D defects, that is extended defects, pores, cracks. Introduction to phase diagram. Phase diagrams can be used to predict the phase changes that have occurred in an alloy that has been exposed to a particular heat treatment process. This is important because the properties of metal component depends on the phases present in the metal. Some of the terms used in phase diagrams are component, pure metal or compound. Example, copper, zinc or copper zinc alloy, sugar, water, solvent. Solvent, most or major component in a solution. Solute, dissolved minor compound in a solution. System, set of possible alloy from same component, example iron carbon system.
Solubility limit,
maximum solute concentration that can be dissolved at a given temperature.
Phase,
part with homogeneous physical and chemical characteristics.
Solid solutions,
a solid solution occurs when alloy two metals and they are completely soluble in each other. If a solid solution alloy is viewed under a microscope, only one type of crystals can be seen, just like a pure metal. Solid solution alloys have similar properties to pure metals but with greater strength, but are not as good as electrical conductors. The common types of solid solutions are substitutional solid solutions and interstitial solid solutions. Substitution solid solution. The name of the solid solution tells you exactly what happens as atoms of the parent metal or solvent metal are replaced or substituted by atoms of the alloying metal, that is solute metal. In this case, the atoms of the two metals in alloy are similar size.
Interstitial solid solutions.
In interstitial solid solutions, the atoms of the parent or solvent material are bigger than the atoms of the alloying or solute metal. In this case, the smaller atom fit into interstices, that is space between the larger
phases.
One phase systems are homogeneous. Systems with two or more phases are heterogeneous or mixes. This is the case of most metallic alloy, but also happens in ceramics and polymer. A two component alloy is called binary. One with three component is called as ternary.
Microstructure.
The properties of an alloy do not depend only on concentration of the phases, but how they are arranged structurally at the microscopy level. Thus, the microstructure is specified by the number of phases, their proportions, and their arrangements in a space.
Solid solutions.
A binary alloy may be a single solid solution, two separate essential pure components, a chemical compound together with a solid solution.
Phase diagram.
A graph showing the phase or phases present for a given composition as a function of a temperature.
Polyphase material,
a material in which two or more phases are present.
Eutectoid,
transforming from a solid phase to two other solid phases upon cooling.
Pertectoid,
transforming from one solid phase to a third solid phase upon cooling.
Pertectoid reaction,
a reaction in which a solid goes into a new solid plus a liquid on heating and reverse occurs on cooling. Iron-iron carbon diagram is essential to understand the basic difference among iron alloy and controlled. Iron is allotropic. At room temperature, pure iron exists in the body concentrated cubic crystal form, but on heating transforms to a phase-ended cubic crystal. The temperature that this first transformation takes place is known as the critical point, and it occurs at 9-10 degrees Celsius. This change in crystalline structure is accompanied by shrinkage in volume, since the atoms in the FCC are more densely packed together than in the BCC crystal. At the second crystalline point, the FCC crystal changes back to BCC crystal, and this change occurs at 1390 degrees Celsius. Iron above 1390 degrees Celsius is known as delta ion. Iron between 1390 and 910 degrees Celsius is known as gamma ion. Iron below 910 degrees Celsius is known as alpha.